Press the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to receive all the latest updates.
Hello guys and welcome to the Photography Blogger. And today I have this box with me, which I ordered like a month back from a website. I'll share the link in the description below. So this is basically a 360 degree electric panorama head, as it reads over here. This is by the brand called AFI. So I'm going to unbox it and tell you some basic features about this. So without any wait, let's get started.
Wait. So before we get started with the video, here's a great news for you guys. So I'm giving this panoramic head as a giveaway. So I'll be selecting one lucky winner who would be getting this. I'll be giving it as a giveaway. So if you want to participate in this giveaway, all you have to do is subscribe to the channel. And the second thing, you have to comment in the section below. Why would you want this as a giveaway? Why do you like this product, or why would you be needing it? And the third thing that you have to do is subscribe to my Instagram handle. So it's given in the description below. These three steps and you're eligible for this giveaway. So that's so easy peasy, right?
So before we go inside, let's see what's written on the box. So over here you can read that this particular device, it allows you to click Bluetooth pictures, panoramic photos, and 10 seconds still camera. You might be thinking what all these things are. I'll take you through in this video. Do not worry about that. On the back end side also, it reads the same features. So it's pretty much same. So let's go inside. I'll just, so there's no seal because it came like this only. So I'll just open it and quickly show you guys what's there. So over here we have this warranty card, I guess. Yeah. So it's a warranty card and a certificate, which say that it's certified by the brand or whatever it is. Some guide over here. So I'll just quickly show you guys. So it's in Chinese, don't worry, it's in English as well. So over here you have everything mentioned over here, from what all accessories you get inside the box, everything. I'll take it through everything in this video. So I'll keep this aside. So the first thing that you find is this remote, and I'll take it through this once. I'll just show you what's inside the box. Then we have this giant UFO looking device. So this is the panoramic head, guys, that you get. So yeah, so here's the on off button. So if I switch it on, you can see the light over there. So that's it, and this is the head, and there's the USB port over here. This is used for charging, so you get this cable which can be used to charge this thing. So I'll keep this cable over here as well. So I'll keep it here. Let's see what more is there. So this is basically a mount which is used. So over here you can fix your smartphone. I'll just show you how. So here's a smartphone, and you can maybe put it like this or put it like this, and then you can quickly close it. So here's, it gets fixed on this thing. So you can do that. So that's how it, and it has a good padding between both the clamps. So do not worry that your phone might get damaged or something. So this is a good padding over here. Then we have, nice. So we have a pouch as well. So you can use this to store all the things that you get in this thing. So you do not have to carry the box everywhere. So we have this pouch as well. Then I think, yeah, this is the GoPro mount that you get along with it. So if you want to attach the action camera, you can do that as well. So it's not only for smartphones, it can be used for action camera as well. And that's there. And yeah, so that's it, guys. That's what you got inside the box. We'll get started. I'll give you a brief overview of how this thing works, how you can use it to experiment different things. So friends, now talking about a brief overview of this particular 360 degree panorama head, panoramic head, or panorama head, whatever you call it. So I'll just take it through. Basically, in like I showed you the unboxing, this is what you get. And now a basic overview. Like I told you, there's a USB socket over here, on and off button. So physically, I think the build quality is really good, and it looks really classy. So I was getting another one, but that was a bit Like this one really looks different and a bit more classy, you would say. So at the bottom we have this mount. So you can use this to put on a tripod or a small tripod that you have for smartphones. And that's it. And guys, avoid moving this thing with your hand, because this might get damaged, as it's mentioned in the manual as well. So that's pretty much it. I think it's really made of good quality and it's sturdy as well. So now I'll take you through some brief features of this thing. So guys, I've put up this mount on the motor head. And now what I'll do is I'll just put the smartphone on this. Let's say at the center, and I'll tighten the screw. So here's it, guys. Sorry for that motion, but I know I should not be doing it because the motor might get damaged. But friends, one thing that you have to do is, first, when you switch on this particular panorama head, what you have to do is you have to connect it via Bluetooth, because without that you would not be able to access this remote. So I'll quickly go to the Bluetooth setting and I'll switch it on. So friends, when you search in the settings, you get the AFI Bluetooth name. So I'll quickly connect to it, and it's getting paired. So I'll just skip this part and take you directly through how it works. So the first thing that you have to do is press the power button to make sure that it's on and you can access the remote, because the Bluetooth is already connected. So now I'll click a photo and show you guys how you can easily use this remote to click photos. So all you have to do is press this button and the photo is clicked. So let's try from some distance as well. Great, so it's working. I'll go a bit far again. No, I think the range is really limited over here. So it's somewhat around 15 inches. So that's a fair distance, but I wish it was a bit more. So now coming on to other feature, which is 10 second photo. So what it allows you to do is, so I'll just press this button and you'll see. So after every 10 seconds, what would happen is your camera would rotate 40 degrees. So in every 10 seconds, it would rotate 40 degrees. So it allows you, for example, if you're clicking, like you see, it has moved. So if you are clicking panorama photos, so you can, it gives you 10 seconds, it moves, you can click a photo, then again it moves, then again you can click a photo. So that's how this feature works. So now coming on to the next feature, which is my favorite and which is the USP of this particular panoramic head. So what it does is, I'll just press this right button and you guys just see what happens. So as you can see, the motor head is moving on its own. So it can be used to create videos or to create something fun out of it, a time lapse or a slow motion as well. So I'll show you guys, there are some more options in this remote. So what it allows you to do is, basically, let's say if you want to speed up this thing, so you can, I'll just show you, this is the max speed that it goes up to, and this is the minimum speed that it goes. So it has some variations of the speed as well, so allowing you to be as slow as this or as fast as this. So I hope you guys like this feature. I found this really interesting. I'll be making some content out of it and posting on my Instagram handle. So if you're not following me on Instagram, you can do so by following the link in the description below. So now this right side means that the device would move in this direction, and if I press the left button, it basically moves in the opposite direction. Yeah, so I'll just press this button and you can see on your own. So right now it's moving in that direction, and if I press this button, it moves on the other direction. And over here, this button, what it does is, it basically, I think it moves in 40 or 45 degrees. So yeah, so as you can see, it's moving 40 degrees towards left and then towards right back. So this is what it allows you to do. So these are all the features that this particular panoramic head has. So guys, let me know your views in the comment section below. I really found this interesting, but not an ideal tool or equipment for making time-lapse videos. Surely it can be for slow motion videos or for clicking panoramic photos. So overall, it's good. The build quality is good. The connectivity was really fine. I was able to find the Bluetooth. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching the video, and do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. Until the next video, take care.